If you want to send WhatsApp messages in Bike to your customers, clients, or basically anyone else, but you don't want the hassle of setting up a WhatsApp API, I've got a very simple solution for you. It's built entirely in Microsoft Excel and lets you send messages right from your own phone number. A couple of years ago, I created the first version of this template, and since then more than 10,000 people have downloaded it. And I've added a ton of new features along the way to make this tool even better. Now there are two versions of this template, a free one and also a paid version with extra features. So in this video I will start by showing you what the paid version can do for you, and towards the end I will also show you what's included in the free version. So without further ado, let me show you how it works.
All you need to do is to input the receiver's number and the text you want to send. You can also choose which files you want to attach to your message. Once that is done, just press this button here and a new Chrome browser window will pop up. If it's your first time using the tool, you will need to scan the QR code to log in to your WhatsApp account. But don't worry, you only need to do this once. The logging data will be stored on your computer, so the next time you run the bot, you won't need to scan the QR code again. Alright, and once you are logged in, go back to Excel. Here you will now see a message box asking you if you are logged in into your account. So in my case, as I'm logged in, I can confirm this by clicking on OK. And now the bot will start sending each message. As you can see here, the bot can also attach files like images and even add a caption. On top of that, you could also attach multiple files to a single message. Now, when it comes to your text messages, you also got a couple of formatting options. For example, you can add line breaks, send bold text, strike through or italic text. On top of that, you can also send messages in any language you want, and the tool also supports emojis. And instead of sending the same message to everyone, you could also personalize each message by using placeholders. I will show you how to set that up in just a bit. Now, another cool feature is that you can even send messages to numbers that aren't in your contact list, which is great if you want to reach a wider audience. Additionally, if you use that feature, so to send messages to unsafe numbers, the tool will automatically detect if the number doesn't exist or isn't registered on WhatsApp. If that is the case, it will simply skip that number and continue sending the rest of the messages. Okay, and once everything is sent, the browser will close and you will get a notification in Excel, letting you know that it's all done. Now, as I mentioned earlier, you only need to scan the QR code once. So the next time you run the bot, you will be logged in automatically. That means once the page is fully loaded, you just confirm this message box here, and then the bot will start sending your messages. By the way, you can also track the sending progress in the status column. Okay, now let me speed things up here so that I can show you how to input your data. If you just want to send a normal text message, set the type to text and enter your message in the following column. By the way, any links you include here will be automatically converted into clickable links in the final message. Now, for sending media files like images or videos, you want to set the type to media. Then input the paths of the files you want to send in here. And if you are sending multiple files to the same number, just separate each file path with a semicolon. Optionally, you could also include a caption for your files. And a quick note here, if you are sending multiple files, the caption will be only added to the first file in your list. Now, similar to media files, you can also attach documents like spreadsheets, PDF, text files, and so on and so forth. Okay, and with that, let's talk about formatting your text, because here you have a couple of options. For example, to add line breaks, you can use a pipe symbol. Additionally, you can also send bold, strike through, or italic text as shown here. And to make your message more personal, you can also use placeholders. There's actually a dedicated sheet for placeholders where you can define either global placeholders or number-specific placeholders. For example, you could input each customer's name and their corresponding number here and define it as a number-specific placeholder. And if you don't know the customer name, you can set a global placeholder as a fallback solution. That means then instead of saying "Hi John," it could say something like "Hi there." And once you have defined the placeholders here, you can then use them in your messages. And the best part is, you can create and use as many placeholders as you want. Okay, and to make your messages even more fun and engaging, you can also include emojis. The tool supports any emoji, as well as any language and special characters, And to show you that, I've included a few examples here. Next up, let's talk about some error handling. If you input a number that's not in your contact list, it will be indicated in the status column. And as I mentioned earlier, you can even send messages to unsaved numbers. To do that, all you need to do is to mark those messages with an X in the following column. Lastly, if you input an invalid file pair for your attachment, the tool will detect it and notify you. And by the way, if you want to take things even a step further, you could even use placeholders in your file paths. So this would allow you then to send different attachments to different receivers. Okay, next up, let me also show you some additional tools that can make your workflow even easier. In some cases, you might have phone numbers that include non-digit characters like spaces, dashes, or other symbols as shown here. For this scenario, I created a number formatter tool. All you need to do is to input your numbers into this section here, click the convert button, and the tool will clean up your numbers. Additionally, if you need to append a country code to your numbers, that's easy too. Just select the country, set the option here to yes, and then click the button again. Now the tool will add the country code to your numbers. Okay, and with that said, let's take a look at another handy tool, which is the phone number replicator. Let's say you want to send a normal text message and also attach an image to the same number. In that case, you will need to fill out two rows with the same number, one for the text and one for the image. Now, instead of manually copying the numbers, you can use this tool here to save you some time. Just input the number and choose how many times you want to replicate each one. When you press the button, the tool will replicate each number for you. And now you can just copy those numbers here and paste them into the bot sheet. Okay, and the last sheet here is the backend settings. Now this part is a bit technical, but don't worry, you don't need to change anything here. The bottom line is that WhatsApp sometimes updates its interface. For example, they might rename or move buttons. However, the bot always needs to know where to click and how to find those buttons, and this is all defined in the settings table here. Now here's the good news, you don't need to worry about any of this. I will keep the tool updated for you. Every time you press the Run WhatsApp button, the latest settings will be automatically pulled from my server and this table will update itself. This means you won't need to download a new version of the tool whenever WhatsApp makes changes. Everything will be handled for you in the background. Alright, and lastly, let me also show you some additional settings. To mimic a more natural sending behavior, you can include random delays between your messages. You can set these release times in the following cells. And also, there's more information about that in the documentation. Next up, let's talk about the requirements to use this tool. And this is pretty simple. All you need is a desktop version of Microsoft Excel, Chrome browser, and also a free tool called VBA Selenium. Setting everything up takes less than 5 minutes. And to make it as easy as possible for you, I created a step-by-step getting started video that will guide you through the entire process. You will find that video in the documentation of this tool. And speaking of this documentation here, one very important part are the guidelines. Because this tool is not meant to be used for spamming people, as that could get your WhatsApp account banned in no time. Instead, it's designed to help you to have a meaningful two-way communication with your customers or clients. So in the guidelines here, I've included some do's and don'ts to help you to use this tool responsibly. Okay, and as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, there are two versions of this tool. The free version allows you to send unlimited text messages, but it doesn't let you send attachments, emojis, or messages to unsaved numbers. So this is what the free version looks like. Now, to get and download the tool, check out the links in the description. In there, I will also include the link to the documentation we have just seen. Okay, and if you still have questions, feel free to leave them in the comments and I will be happy to answer them. As always, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.